Hello and welcome to Chairside Live. I'm Megan Strong.
And I'm Will Schmidt, Registered Dental Assistant here at Gladwell Dental.
So today we've got part two of Dr. Chi's Bruxer aesthetic case. He was replacing a couple PFMs on number 7 and number 10. The first episode, he gave us an overview of the case,
right,
showed us the final result. But so what's happening on this second segment?
Well, Megan, we're going to continue this case. We're going to see Dr. Chi remove these PFMs, do the buildups, and then he's going to do what he's best known for, and that's digital scanning with the iTero Element digital scanner.
That's right, and he's using the incredible Gladwell.io in-office solution to fabricate provisional crowns with BioTemps NOW.
Really?
Yes.
BioTemps NOW with the Gladwell.io in-office solution and the fast mill?
Yes.
Megan, I'm telling you, the provisional revolution is upon us.
It's upon us, so let's take a look and see part two.
Welcome back to part two, where I'll now take you through the prep and impression for the Bruxer aesthetic restorations that we placed on tooth numbers 7 and 10. We'll start with the removal of the PFM crowns, where I use a carbide 557 burr to create a slot through the crowns along the facial, incisal, and lingual surfaces. It's pretty easy to tell once we've cut through a PFM, since the transition from metal to tooth prep beneath is pretty obvious. Once the slot is large enough, I use a Christensen crown remover to separate the crown from the prep. For more stubborn crowns, like on number 10, I make an additional horizontal slot to help with the removal. Once the crowns are removed, it's time to refine the preps and also to modify the buildups if necessary. The gingival zenith on number 7 is about half a millimeter lower than number 10, so I'm just checking the sulcular depth with the probe to make sure I have enough room from the attachment to raise the margin. For all my preps, I use a round-ended tapered diamond burr to create the appropriate depth and rounded internal angles along the axial surfaces, which will result in a deep chamfer margin. For Bruxer aesthetic, we're looking for a reduction of about 0.7 millimeters along the gingival margins and a 1.5 millimeter clearance. To remove the temporary filling material on number 10, I use a carbide round burr at a slow speed. This helps ensure I don't remove much tooth structure beyond the temp material. Once I reach the gutta percha, I seal the top with Vitrobond glass ionomer. Now to start the buildup, I use Kerr's 37% phosphoric acid etch for 10 seconds, followed by OptiBond Universal. After I apply a bonding agent, I always use air and suction to remove excess bonding agent and also to evaporate the solvents. Once the bonding agent has been light cured for 10 seconds, I incrementally use camouflage nanohybrid flowable composite so the buildup is well adapted to the teeth. Once the buildups are cured, I'll continue refining the preps to ensure that there is adequate reduction and the internal surfaces are rounded and smooth. Since the margins are slightly subgingival, I use a size 1 core to help retract the tissue for the impression. In tight spaces, I use both a perioprobe and a serrated cord packer to place the cord just below the margins. After 5 minutes, I remove the cords and dry the preps and sulcus really well for the digital impression. Any excess fluids on the preps or within the sulcus can certainly create distortions within the impression. On the iTero Element scanner, we first capture a high-resolution image of each prep, then the rest of the neighboring teeth in the upper arch, the opposing arch, and then we finish with the patient biting together to establish the occlusion. Taking impressions with a digital scanner is an active process where you sweep the scanner along all of the surfaces of the teeth while observing the model that's generating on the screen. After each set, it's important to analyze the model to ensure the necessary areas have been captured. Since the final restorations will be Bruxer aesthetic, the digital impression has been transferred to the lab for fabrication. I also transfer the files to our Gladwell in-office system so I can design and mill precise-fitting BioTemps NOW provisionals. In the Fast Design software, I first mark the margins and define the occlusal and facial directions. Once the margins are placed, if necessary, it's easy to modify the margins by dragging the line around. Once the margins are completed, both restorations can be designed simultaneously. Here I'm using a tool called Freeform that can allow custom adjustments to any area of the design. Once the design is complete, I'll automatically set the proximal contact values using the Edit Contacts window here on the right. The designs are then transferred to the fast mill, where it'll take 6 minutes to make a perfect fitting provisional out of the BioTemps NOW blocks. Once each sprue connection has been removed, we use Voco Bifix Temp, which is a very strong and easy to use composite-based temporary cement. Since these restorations fit so well and the margins are so precise, it certainly offers a peace of mind during this temporary phase while we wait for the final restorations to be fabricated. That wraps things up for part two of this case. On the next episode of Chairside Live, I'll take you through the final delivery of these Bruxer aesthetic restorations on tooth numbers 7 and 10.
Well, thank you for that, Dr. Chi. Be sure to tune back in for the third and final installment of this very exciting case.
It's going to be a good one. Can't wait to see it get wrapped up. Speaking of wrapped up, today's episode, we're wrapping it up. On behalf of everyone here at Glywell Dental, thank you so much for watching.
And we'll meet you right back here next time.